Welcome back to part two of my five-part series exploring what life was like in Australia's inland seas during the age of dinosaurs. If you haven't done so already, go and watch part one first to learn about the origin story of the first inland sea. Otherwise, in today's episode, part two, you're going to learn all about the rare fossils and dramatic events of the second inland sea. By 125 million years ago, sea levels had risen once more. The second inland sea spread even further than the first inland sea, extending even further into New South Wales. The evidence of this event comes from rocks in the Bungle Formation of Queensland. Once again, there are only a few places where surface rocks allow for fossils to be unearthed. Marine bivalves and snails are some of those rare fossils that have been discovered. There is also evidence of two meteorites crashing into the second inland sea. The first is called the Tucanuca impact structure. About 125 million years ago, this meteor crashed into the sea near Eromanga. The crater nowadays is below the ground, but we can detect it with geological equipment. The crater is around 66 kilometers wide. At around the same time, the second meteor left an even bigger crater, 84 kilometers wide. Found near the town of Blackall, this is known as the Talon-Dilly structure. As the second inland sea retreated, these meteorite impacts would have been visible and exposed to the elements for a time, but not for long. Before long, the third inland sea soon encroached and made it disappear beneath the waves. By 115 million years ago, the third Eromanga Sea had returned to flood Central Australia. The third inundation represented the largest inland sea Australia has ever known. It's this sea that starts leaving behind the extensive fossil-rich rocks of the Eromanga Sea. These fossils included gigantic marine reptiles such as Kronosaurus. In these rocks, we can finally learn about the predators that hunted in Australian waters. Join us next time for part three, where you will learn about the marine life of the third inland sea.